Thank you very much. Look.
Election night, 1992. President George Bush concedes defeat.
I just called Governor Clinton over in Little Rock and offered my congratulations.
Surrounded by his family, he closes his political career. But if two of his sons who were with him that night have their way, a Bush political dynasty is on the verge of being born.
Good to see y'all, thanks.
George W. Bush, known as George W., is running for governor of Texas.
Have you ever held public office?
No, I have not, and that's a strength, not a weakness, in 1994.
Good afternoon, I'm Jeb Bush.
And John Ellis Bush, known as Jeb, is running for governor of Florida.
Are you tough enough to be governor?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I'm passionate enough, and I have the energy and intensity to do this, and the joy.
George W. Bush.
And, of course, both sons have the family name and active help in their campaigns from their mother, the popular former first lady, and from their father, the former president.
Elect this man.
Who, though he may have lost the last election, carried Florida and Texas handily.
Hi, boy.
Were the parents surprised by their son's decision to run?
Did they come and ask your advice and say,
no.
Dad?
No, but I was a little surprised because, frankly, 1992 was a rather hurtful year for our family, and they were right shoulder to shoulder with their dad. But I wasn't long-run surprise. I mean, I think they want to serve.
What are the differences that you see between these two sons?
George says people tell him that he inherited his father's eyes and brains and my mouth. But
he didn't mean it in an unkind way.
Oh,
do you
really?
George W. Bush, at 48, is a managing general partner of the Texas Rangers baseball team. Like his father, he's a former oil man from Midland, Texas, who now lives in Dallas with his wife, Laura, and twin daughters, Barbara and Jenna. For the girls, politics can be a hurtful experience.
I mean, last night, there was a bad commercial.
What do they say about him in the commercials?
He only owns 2% of the Rangers.
And then if he, like, is a failed businessman or something.
Well, how do you think he's done? I mean, he's a businessman.
I don't really know. I think the Rangers haven't won the World Series yet.
The other brother, Jeb, is 41. He moved to Florida in 1980 with his wife, Columba, whom he met in her hometown of Leon, Mexico, when he went there as an exchange student.
And I fell madly in love with her.
At first sight?
At first sight.
Columba Bush's fluency in Spanish is a campaign asset in South Florida. They have three children. The youngest, 10-year-old Jeb Jr., travels with them on the bus. And as the country learned back in 1988, when Vice President Bush pointed him out to President Reagan, their grandparents dote on them.
Well, everyone remembers in 1988, they're my little brown ones.
To this day, from time to time, someone will bring that up as if it was a derogatory thing, and they don't know George Bush very well.
Hello, everybody. I'm Prescott Bush, Republican candidate for the United States Senate.
To understand the Bush family's closeness, one only needs to look at the pictures from the era of the candidate's grandparents. Prescott Bush was a New York banker who lived in Connecticut and represented that state in the Senate for 10 years until 1963. His son George, of course, went on to be president. And George's children just naturally grew up lending a hand to the family business of politics.
There's that wonderful story in Washington about how when your dad wanted to fire John Sununu, he sent you to do it.
True. It was a great honor for me to be picked.
To fire John Sununu?
No, just to be by my dad's side. Really, I mean, you got to understand, we love our dad.
For the first time in my life, I was giving a speech, and he was in the crowd. And I looked at him, and he looked at me, and it was difficult. It was very difficult. I got choked up. It was a nice but very emotional moment. I'd kill for my dad.
Both sons may love their father, but they are preaching a fierce anti-government conservative message. It must make the former president of the long public service resume wince. Jeb says government must be clubbed into submission.
That's the first step of the new relationship. I think government's too big.
I am not happy with.
And George W. assaults the practices of established politicians, sparing no one.
One of the problems with our state and our country is when political leaders put political head fakes on the citizenry say one thing is going to play like one thing is going to happen and it not happen.
Mr. Bush, are you really complaining about politicians who say they're going to do one thing and turn around doing something else? You know who I'm talking about.
Read my lips. No.
I understand, Sam. We're all learners.
I mean, your dad said, read my lips, then decided to do something else. And a lot of people think that's what defeated him.
Could have been. That's why I'm not going to make political promises that I cannot fulfill.
Are these sons of yours a little bit more conservative on the issues than you are?
I don't do issues anymore, but nor do I follow it that closely to know what position each is taking on every issue. But I think, there may be differences on issues. I'm sure there are, but it doesn't matter. It's not we're then, they're now.
Not so fast. They're not now, yet. If this man has his way, Jeb Bush won't be elected governor of Florida. Democrat Lawton Childs is the governor and wants to stay there.
I'm up to bat now. It's my turn.
And he's coming on strong with an old-time style reminiscent of the days before television put a premium on polish. The contrast on the stump between the veteran office holder of 34 years and his younger, button-down opponent who has never held elective office couldn't be more vivid.
He's your man if you believe in the status quo. Re-elect him.
Can Childs be painted as out of touch?
Press any key to go on.
Oh. Governor Jeb Bush says that you're a nice man, but your day is past.
I've kind of characterized Jeb Bush again as a nice young man, but his ideas are back to the 80s. 75% of the things that he's talking about are things that we're already doing. The other 25% are crazy as heck.
Heck?
Well, I knew you. I didn't want to offend you, Sam.
Good to see y'all. You're looking good.
And over in Texas, if this woman has her way, George W. won't be governor either. Democrat Ann Richards has the job and wants to keep it. Like Lawton Childs, she knows how to energize a crowd.
I see the man on TV, and he may be only a 2% owner of his ball club, but he has been running down Texas 100% of the time.
In this race, there is, of course, a history.
Poor George.
Richards burst on the national scene back in 1988 at the Democratic Convention.
He can't help it.
When she said of the senior George Bush,
he was born with a silver foot in his mouth.
It's a great line, isn't it? And that line will go down in history. I had no idea that that line would have such a hook in it.
Would it be sweet if she's defeated by your son?
Well, it would be sweet if our son won, but there's no personal vendetta on this. In either race. Doesn't matter. Let the boys handle it. They don't need editorializing from their dad about, hey, this is a little bit of an insult to your father. Go out there and remedy this. I mean, there's none of that in this.
Grudge or not, they're swinging hard at each other in Texas. Bush accuses Richards of being soft on crime.
Violent juvenile crime is up 52%, yet Ann Richards has done little about it.
Every other Bush business venture has lost money, big money.
And Richards accuses Bush of being a business failure.
Texas is on the comeback trail, but can we afford the business experience of George W. Bush?
Both, of course, deny the other's accusations. But all that is mild compared to what is happening in Florida. For instance,
14 years ago, my daughter rode off to school on her bicycle. She never came back. Her killer still on death row, and we're still waiting for justice.
A Bush ad features the mother of a dead teenager who implies that Childs has refused to sign the convicted murderer's death warrant.
I know Jeb Bush. He'll make criminals serve their sentences and enforce the death penalty. Lawton Childs won't.
In fact, the case is still in the courts, and until it's resolved, a death warrant could not be enforced. Two nights ago, they debated that and other issues in a televised slugfest.
I'm not attacking Governor Childs' character. I do believe he has been a liberal on crime and soft on crime.
You put on this ad, Jeb. You knew it was false. It's demagoguery, pure and simple.
And on immigration,
I called, put the National Guard on alert. And I told the federal government, either you stop Castro or we will. The federal government did stop him, and this time we won and Castro lost.
I don't think you stopped Fidel Castro. He's still in power. And when you saw the food riots, you should have been up there with your good friend Bill Clinton saying, this is the chance to strike.
For Jeb Bush, such a toe-to-toe slugfest is, by his own admission, somewhat out of character.
What's the difference between a Floridian and a Texan?
And I think the Texans are a little more theatrical. They have a little better flair to them, perhaps.
He's more aggressive.
He's more aggressive, I think. I'm accused of being Motorolan, which is a term that inside the campaign of being kind of focused on the inner workings of things.
Are the Bushes competitive within the family?
On sports, you bet. But not in politics. Is not a zero-sum game in this case. I hope he wins. Regardless of what happens to me, I hope he wins.
If either one wins, the issues and personalities notwithstanding, they will owe their election to a large extent to the fact that they come from such famous stock. That's something their opponents are grappling with.
I think it's important to remember that he has his father's name. A funny thing happened in one of the phone banks. Somebody got a woman on the other end of the line, and she said, I don't think he ought to get to run for governor. After all, he's still the president of the United States.
Florida's not for sale. We're not going to sell the governorship of Florida.
Is that what the Bush family's trying to do, buy it?
I think that if John Ellis's last name was Childs, or Smith, or Donaldson, this would be a different race.
Critics say, well, you know, they're just here because they're George and Barbara Bush's son.
Baloney. That's my answer. What's yours?
No, they do say that, though.
Critics?
But that's not right, because they've been successful, and their platforms will stand on their own, and their records will stand on their own.
Whether you like it or not, there's a Bush dynasty that may be created.
Well, there's a Roosevelt running this year, and a Rockefeller, and a Rodham, and a Kennedy. Are you claiming all those are dynasties?
Well, we'll see after November the 8th.
Won't we?